Hello and welcome to the show. We are back at the Bajarama circuit, going to be driving three more vehicles till destruction, starting with the ETKS series. Now, the ETKs have got considerably stronger, and I did notice when looking at this mod, one of the recent updates for it increased the strength of the suspension. So, fingers crossed, this will actually be able to make it off of its opening lap. To help it along, we have also got all-wheel drive. This is about the highest tier of ETKS series that you can get. It's got a turbocharged V12. Which is always nice. It is the long wheelbase variant, so it is a relatively large car. However, I am hoping that it can do relatively well. There is a lot of speed. In fact, there's so much speed, we've got to be careful in places that we don't go soaring off of the map, because it would be very easy to accelerate it fast enough to do so. Now, that speed will be good when it comes to places like Radiator Springs. It probably won't matter too, unless we have like a horrendous issue running up towards Radiator Springs. It probably won't matter too much how we approach it, because we should have more than enough acceleration to get away with it. But all of that acceleration does come with its own set of potential problems. You see, yes, you will be hitting the jumps a lot faster. However, that does tend to mean that you hit the landings a lot harder. And this car here is also seeming to like to fly a little bit nose down, which isn't particularly great. In fact, it's quite viciously nose down, in fact. And yeah, when you hit the landings of these jumps with a lot of force, that can create some problems. Oh, that's a lot more speed than I wanted to take over there. Uh-oh. No, don't. Ooh. Okay, if you want to right yourself while out here, that's fine by me. That's actually worked out surprisingly well. Really? Really? That's what the little... Apparently the radiator's not the strongest thing in this car. The exhaust is flapping about wildly at the back there. Now, we've got to get this thing, try and slow it down across these initial bumps up here. We should now be able to accelerate away plentifully across there. That's the ticket. We've lost one of the exhaust. Now, skidding along on your roof, while it looks like it wrecks the car, this looks horrendously broken, that's okay, because, well, while all the damage being done to the roof, it's not being done to the important mechanical bits. Sadly, yeah, the radiator went as we came back onto the map. Little bit of a shame, however, yeah, not a huge amount that can be done about it. This is an area that I think the S series might get into trouble with. We're going to lose control of the car if we're not careful. We've got some. come on, car. We'll get it back into a rhythm eventually. Down here, because the car is so quick, we're hitting the ground pretty fast. I want to keep the nose up. I just can't get it to keep the nose up. Theoretically, this would have the speed to kind of get doubles. It might have the speed to be able to do this. I don't know. It's going to be, you've got to be very, very careful across the first one. Because if you overshoot the first one, it's not quite got enough. Oh, that's going to hit the front. Then we're going to flip. And come back down without any major damage. Yeah, the problem is, if you go too quick over the first one, you're going to land awkwardly for the second bit, or for the first of the trebles. But if you don't go quick enough, which is what we didn't quite do there, you can still make the first bit of the jump, but then you're not going fast enough for the first of the triples. And while, yeah, this car has got the speed, it's not quite enough to get away with what I wanted it to do there. Oh dear, we've got some big oversteer issues. We're going to go around in a circle, aren't we? Not that, again, really makes a huge amount of problem for this car. The issue we have now is, of course, overheating. We are very much on borrowed time. And let's face it, it is quite evident as we are going to, well, get onto a second lap, far surpass the previous S-Series. Evident how much stronger this car is. That was a big crash down the motocross jumps, and we have survived. We've got a little bit of bench steering going on. You know, the suspension is collapsing around the car. However, still drivable. And that is the critical bit. You do that with the S-Series of old, or any of the ETKs of old, and that would have probably lost all of its wheels, to be honest. In that crash, it would have probably lost both front wheels. And we might well have lost both back, but we can see how bent up the back of the car is. Oh, we've got big oversteer coming up here. It doesn't really matter. We've gone and got a nice enough landing. We've got some big difficulties turning to the left. We seem to have lost all speed, all ability to do that. And of course, as we take more and more damage, it's then a little bit trickier to get the car accelerated away towards the next jump. Yeah, that massive understeer to the left isn't going to help matters particularly. We should still be fine to a clear here. Oh, although we're going to then pull massively. That's not good. Oh, okay, we're fine. We got away. surprisingly, without snapping a wheel off in that tubby. You can see the camber we've got going on in the rear wheels. That's not going to help matters back there. The rear left is now twisted slightly, but it hasn't fallen off. I can deal with twisted because that's still drivable. It's when it falls off, that's when we have a problem. It's not good across these bumps anymore. Come on, S-Series, use that acceleration. Make sure we clear radiator springs. Indeed, we do. Not the most comfortable of clearings of radiator springs. However, we have got across it. Temperature is now starting to rise. We might just about sneak it on to its third lap. I'm not sure we can do a huge amount more than that. Or the steering makes this quite a difficult car to drive. Or the wheel alignment, I should probably say, makes it quite a difficult car to drive. But it's holding up well. It is holding up well to the punishment. It is being dished out a fair amount. So we can get across there. But we're so awkward on the landing that I can't then get it... Yeah, he's just constantly bouncing. It won't get back into any form of control, and then that means that we're always horrendous. Actually, this is not as bad as it was the first time. We managed to get it a little bit more nose up across here. Oh, that's a big clonk there. However, we're still going. The coolant is now overheating, as slightly expected, really. Can we get the treble this time? We can, but we're going to lose control of our car on the landing. Uh-oh, that's big on the front left. Try and get the car away from the edge of the map. Now that's a new place to go exploring. Not the first car to fall off the edge of the map at that point. I think there was a bus got stuck up there. However, yeah, not ideal. Not ideal for the S-Series. We've got big steering dramas now. The car will turn to the left, but it now won't turn to... It will turn to the right ever so slightly. I thought we were having problems. Oh, no. Stop bouncing around, car. Quickly, not fast enough. Oh, that's killed all of the drive shafts. All of the drive shafts at once. That's an unusual one. That's a... Of all of the collisions that it could have broken that on, it's that that did it in. Well, I mean, we've got all four wheels on. The car is a horrendous, horrendous state. The steering was... I mean, you can see what state the steering was at. It's all completely buckled and twisted. Yeah, surprised to see that was a drive shaft failure. Both drive shaft failures as well. Normally you only get one go at once, and we've had much bigger crashes. Much bigger crashes went on. I guess it's just the damage added up and added up and added up, and eventually something was going to have to go. I don't know if we can actually have a look under here to try and see. I wonder if we just twisted the chassis in such a way that... or maybe it was like twisted up the engine in such a way that it snapped the drive shafts off before... I say before the transfer case, not quite how it works. But either way, whatever we hit on that jump, that certainly wasn't the heaviest of landings we took. That was enough to kill off the S-Series. A massive improvement, though, over the previous car. While, yeah, this was a faster version, it took so many more bigger hits. And, yeah, we still did have a working steering and you know, drivable, wonky, but drivable car when the drive shafts finally gave up. Up next, we have got the Aluda. I believe a vehicle based on the Buick GSX, if I've got my muscle cars remembered correctly. It is a classic American vehicle, and these have traditionally gone very, very well in this series. After all, the Caldara leaves the table. That was based on a Dodge... Well, the normal Caldara is a Dodge Charger. The Daytona version, well, the Dodge Daytona at the top of the table. The Moonhawk survived three laps on fire. The Barstow is really the only exception, and that's down to its drive shaft being made of glass. So there is a certain amount of expectation on a car like this to do well around this course. Like, I kind of expect this vehicle to make it getting on towards three laps, maybe not quite as far as the Daytona. That survived because of the huge nose cone on the front. Took so much of the damage before we started breaking radiators and wheels and so on, and this doesn't have that. It doesn't have that sort of crumple zone at the front to absorb the damage. But you know, the standard Moonhawk, if you like, did very, very well on its own. So we could perhaps expect to see this, yeah, getting around that sort of a level. It's not quite as quick as I was expecting, and I'm also not so sure about that rear suspension anymore. That does seem to be... maybe it's not collapsed. Yeah, these sort of cars often come with the Wobble-Matic suspension option, which, while not great for circuit racing, can actually work quite well out here. It kind of gives a little bit of compliance, it kind of takes a little bit of the punishment early on, and does tend to keep them alive for that tad bit longer, although when it goes, that tends to then give you a lot of trouble. The car will often bounce around uncontrollably on landings of jumps, and I think that's probably what we're going to be seeing here in a relatively short amount of time, since it's twisting and bucking around over here. Come on, can we clear radiator springs? Oh, it's going to be close. It's not enough. Oh, we're over, though. It's not enough to clear it cleanly. And we have gone for a little bit of a skid on our roof. However, importantly, well, the radiator is in one piece. I mean, the car is a little bit... Ooh, the chassis is quite buckled. The roof line isn't the worst we've seen from a tumbled car, but the chassis does look at a really poorly angle in places. That's okay for now. For now, that's not a major problem. I mean, we've had a lot worse steering cars go for a lot longer, so the radiator's okay. We've not got to that sort of ticking time bomb stage yet. Oh, we're only just clearing these, though. I was expecting a little bit more performance from this one. I went for the kind of relatively basic spec of this. There are all sorts of engines and turbo or superchargers you can put on and so on. I gave it the big block V8, but other than that, relatively basic spec of car. And I was expecting a little bit more performance from it, I'll be honest. It doesn't have it. At least, though, again, we're going across these jumps. It sounds nasty. Oh, that's probably not going to be so good for the front of the car. It sounds like nasty impacts that we've got going on with the floor. However, we are managing to keep all the important bits away from any serious damage. Oh, that's only just across there, though, isn't it? Oh, that's going to clip the back of the vehicle. Kind of surprised that didn't go up in flames. Thankful that it got... I don't want another fireball. We've had more drivable fireballs than I was expecting with this series, I'm going to be honest. There have been quite a few cars that have just gone up for various reasons. Oh, we've got big problems with that rear axle. We went around that corner and it just stopped. It stopped driving. It's so twisted at the back now that the diff might actually give us some issues. Okay, this is starting to prove problematic. Now, this won't be the first car that's had rear axle wobble. Might be the first car to go out with. That's really bad. It's almost like all the suspension has kind of come slightly the rear axle has become unconnected from the car and it's just held on by the suspension. That's kind of what it looks like a little bit. That's not great. I don't know whether we can lose... Can you lose the entire rear axle out of cars on here? If that is a thing, I would not be surprised if that happens to this vehicle. Radiator springs isn't going to be fun this time around. It's bumpy. It is very bumpy on the way up to radiator springs, and this car's not going to like that. And then we want to try and put some power. I think we're going to go face first into radiator springs. That's not good. Although, thankfully, we've just got the right amount of speed over there to at least make it partway up the jump, so we get a fairly smooth landing. How are we going to do up this hill? Can we still clear the first part? Yes, we can. Actually, we clonk the front of the chassis on the thing, on the ground. The thing. I know what the ground is called, honestly. The ride height is not the worst we've seen, but it does kind of look like we're going to end up hitting the front end of the chassis, kind of around where the gearbox is, around where the drive shaft is. A little bit concerned we might end up snapping all of that parts off. We will have to wait and see, though. Yeah, that front is taking an absolute battering. However, surprisingly, radiator's still okay. Obviously well protected at the front there as we come up towards radiator springs now. This is where it's going to be not a huge amount of fun for the car. Oh, it actually made it better than the first time around. It's bent the shape. In fact, it's kind of bent the chassis back into shape. It hit it on the mid part that has now crumpled the car back out in a different direction. That's quite impressive going. Yeah, that's actually kind of sorted a few of my handling problems. That is the first time radiator springs has ever been useful, ever, in this series. The crash damage has actually made the car better, the way that it's twisted the chassis back again on itself. Well, we're now surprisingly at a healthier state than we were last time around. I'm not sure this motocross section is going to particularly agree with the car, but we're going to just kind of keep going. I'm amazed how well the front of the vehicle is holding up. We've just managed to keep it away from the worst of the damage. It's been kept away from radiator springs, although I'm not sure. Oh yeah, that rear axle got again. You can see by how much the back of the car is tilted. Radiator spring fixed it briefly. Oh crap, I was in third gear. Didn't want to be in third gear. That's not good. We've gone for a tumble, we've gone for a roll, although we have skidded, again, we're on our roof. We're skidding down the road on our roof is not doing any damage to the car. So, when I say doing any damage to the car, I mean it's wrecked the roof, but it's not actually doing any important mechanical damage to the car. That might have, the front is, there goes the radiator. It has finally gone, however, when this is looking pretty good to, well, I mean, maybe even potentially go on to challenge that Daytona. I don't know how long it's going to take the engine to overheat, and I don't know how long it's going to be before other important bits at the front start going, like steering, because we are now really hitting the front of the car hard. Like, that is taking some absolutely brutal punishment at the front. The rear axle's still broken, but, as I say, still broken, still wonky as anything. It's not going to magically fix itself. It would be helpful if radiator springs had magically fixed the rear axle, but it's not going to happen. Oh dear, come on, get turned. It's starting to get to the flatmobile levels of the Covert that I ran over with a monster truck. It's starting to get that, not quite that ridiculous yet, but it is starting to get there. No, sudden oversteer. I have to say, all things considered, again, the punishment that this car has been through, it is driving remarkably well in terms of alignment, in terms of driving in a straight line. Again, we'll clonk across there, but no massive harm has been done to it. Well, I mean, if we can clear radiator springs this time around, or if we don't lose a rear wheel doing something like that, yeah, if we can clear radiator springs this time around, I wonder if this could go further than the Daytona. I think radiator springs is going to be the real test. If we get a good run up towards it, then I think we can possibly do it, because the damage isn't really slowing us down much from where it was to begin with, or from where it was last lap. However, if we do start getting bounced around, the suspension is more damaged, that much is for sure. So if we get a poor run up here and I'm struggling, we might be in a bit of bother here. I don't really know. I can't change gear because first gear is not going to work down here, so we've got to kind of keep it in second and hope. Come on, Eluda, you could not do it. Nope, not do it. Bad things. Even if the drive shaft hadn't gone, we'd lost a wheel anyway, so it'd probably only be a matter of time. It was close. It was close to making it across radiator springs, I think. One time too many for the poor Eluda. And yeah, that time we got the drive shaft. The radiator held on for a mega amount of time. I think that's one of the longest surviving radiators on this vehicle. If we could have made it across there, then yeah, potentially we could have gone, because I mean the temperature, we can see, not massively high yet, we could have potentially gone on to challenge that Daytona, but just more and more damage being piled onto the car, suspension damage and so on, struggling to make speed when the car wasn't massively quick, let's face it, to begin with, always likely to be a little bit of a bother. You can see how twisted and buckled the chassis is under here. Considerably better than it would have been if I'd rolled it on lap one or whatever, because it sort of rebent itself out. But yeah, spectacular nevertheless, and a worthy effort from the Eluda, but just not quite enough speed to make it across radiator springs, and that would be the end of the drive shaft. And for our final vehicle, I have got an estate car, a very, very fast modified racing estate car, because there needs to be more fast estate cars in games, and I fancied having a go with something different. So we're going to see how this Pazima might fare. As you can see, very, very low to the ground, very, very sporty suspension and so on. Perhaps not the greatest in terms of survivability around the Baja circuit, but we have thought that before about race cars, and they have done fairly well in the past. There is a lot of speed. That was a very, very silly place to go exploring. There's a lot more speed than I was expecting in some ways from this car. And yeah, you can get yourself in a little bit of trouble with this one. Strength-wise, while yes, you know, the car is much lower to the ground on the race suspension does tend to be a little bit stronger. Might survive a few more impacts. Likewise, with the high-performance radiator that's going to be in this car, it's stronger and does take a few more impacts to kill, which is good, because it's going to have a fair few to survive, I would expect. Much like I said with the S series, when you get to this sort of level of speed, the impacts on the landing of jumps are very, very ferocious, so it's going to need that strength. I do think something's gone awry, probably with the rear axle. I don't know, the car kind of feels like it's crabbing slightly, which is never a good thing to have a vehicle do ever. Maybe it was just the terrain at that part of the road that we were driving down that gave it some issues. Now, radiator springs, we should be good to clear. Even with a sort of wonky approach such as this, we should have more than enough speed to be able to accelerate our way across, and indeed we do. That rear axle is looking... The rear wheels are looking... a little bit dodgy. I think that they're starting to get quite cambered, a lot more than they were to begin with. And I think they've been sort of squashed up into the car. So that's not going to help us. The more damage that ends up going on there... Oh, yeah, you can kind of see. If there were collisions between the wheels and the bodywork, yeah, we'd be kind of shredding our own tyres at this stage. And as they get more and more damaged, that's only going to get worse. And places like down here, where everything gets a little bit... bouncing. That's because the rear suspension doesn't know what to do with itself across here. It's just completely and utterly crippled. Thankfully, it's not affecting us too much in terms of drivability on the most part. Like, it's not affecting our cornering ability, and we might be able to... We've got quite a lot of understeer around there. We might be able to get some trebles going on. Oh, it's very, very close. Oh, that's actually now soared a little too far. Uh-oh. Okay, no, we're good. Oh, we're not good. Just see what it's done to the rear wheel. Oh, rear wheel axle's gone. Radiator's gone. Damn it. Almost made it. We almost made it. Now, the car is probably still going to be workable here. It is, as I said, all-wheel drive. Now, losing that rear wheel has now made us front-wheel drive. I doubt the differential is going to let the other rear wheel work. So we do now have a front-wheel drive car. Front-wheel drives have survived. I think the furthest we've got a front-wheel drive car is 3 laps. So that is something to aim for, potentially. Oh, crap. The issue is we are struggling massively for performance now as, yeah, the front wheels are dragging it around and the diff's a bit crap. The wheel is... I mean, I'd rather kind of lose a rear wheel in this instance because while it's there and it's kind of flapping around doing its own thing... It doesn't matter if that's at a wonky angle because it's not going to be dragging us about too much. If it's a front wheel that gets snapped, that's where we have real issues. Oh, well, we've got rid of the rear bumper. Not my intention. We had a huge chronic understeer, but we have got rid of the rear bumper there. I am struggling for power in this car quite a lot. I'd say you're struggling for power. I'm struggling to put that power down. I don't know if it's all just getting wasted through the diffs or something, because something isn't happy in here anymore. We are on to our second lap. I'm not sure we're going to survive radiator springs on our second lap, because while we were more than quick enough to accelerate up across it last time around, that was with the full amount of power available in this car, and we don't have that anymore. A lot of it is being wasted through a system. I'm not quite sure which bit of it is causing it to go. However, yeah, the loss of that rear wheel isn't particularly great. Nevertheless, I'm going to keep going as long as I don't lose the other one. Actually, I don't know if losing the other one might be better so that the diff stops stops being confused at the back there. Might make my life easier. Just having the front wheels working. That's how the flappy wheels Bajarama. The flappy wheels Bajarama wasn't all-wheel drive, but yeah, that kind of clawed itself around with the front-wheel drive. Oh, the other issue is that the coolant is overheating now because I'm having to work the car so hard. Oh, that's probably going... Oh, amazingly, we survived that. I was going to say, the overheating was going to be a secondary issue if that had done as much damage as I thought it did. Surprisingly, it's still working. We did take a knock on the run up to radiator springs. We took a knock that's bent the front left wheel in. But I was fully expecting that to be kind of inconsequential after going across radiator springs. That hit very hard at the front there. That's a bit unfortunate. I'll say it's a bit unfortunate. It's fortunate we got away with it. A bit unfortunate we were as broken as we were for the car. We're going to overheat. We're going to just blow the engine to bits. We'll have to try and work it so hard to get it around the course that I think that's going to go fairly quickly. I doubt we're going to make it down the motocross section, but if we can just inch it that little bit further, try and get it as far as we can down here would be nice. Ooh! That all got very, very unhappy. Yeah, the lowered racing estate car, perhaps not the greatest for surviving this course. Always likely to be the way, the sort of speeds this car could obtain. One awkward landing, one, you know, not quite perfect run up towards a jump, gets twisted, likely to cause the wheels, likely to cause the suspension issues. We have, I believe, made it further than the big 8x8 utility truck, though, which is something. I believe the van, that overheated somewhere down this section. Not quite sure how far down here. So if we can keep going... that's the engine gone anyway. Doesn't matter. I don't think if we right the car, pretty sure that engine is not going to turn back on. No, it isn't. Well, I could... I would say perhaps not massively surprising from the Bajarama. One big hit, and it was always likely to be in trouble with this car, quite frankly. The wheels held up relatively well. I mean, it drove for quite a long time. It drove almost a full lap with just front-wheel drive, and it would be the overheating that killed it. It made it across radiator springs with a massive impact on the front. It made it across radiator springs. So that is certainly something it has done. Relatively well considering the damage sustained on lap one, but the suspension was always likely to be the weak link in this one. Wouldn't take long to collapse it, and once it's gone, yeah, the speeds this is taking across the jumps, it's just not strong enough to deal with that. Well, it's a little bit of a sorry sight for our poor estate car. However, still, making it around, you know, a decent way around the two laps is mighty respectable in its own right. So, on to our leaderboard, and the Eluda could not quite make its way into the top 10. I'll have to settle for a 13th place. Very, very close between that and the Regency. I'm talking fractions, probably less than a meter between the pair of them. The Regency managing to sort of skittle on the road on its side just a little bit further. Still, though, you know, 13th place is not too bad at all. It beats the Malik, it beats the 200BX, the I-Series race car, the Flappy Wheels, Bajarama. Yeah, a very good car around this course. Probably one of the highest ranking cars that really did not have a huge amount of speed. I mean, the Malik is probably the closest comparison in terms of speed. So yeah, it did well for itself. We have to go a bit further down to find our other car today. The Long Wheelbase S-Series is in 28th place with its two dry shaft failures. Another very, very close one between that and the Volkswagen Fox. The Fox, though, did manage to roll a little bit further around the corner when its engine cut out. The S-Series, not quite as much. But it does, interestingly, go ahead of the all-wheel drive K-Series that went out last time. Again, surprisingly similar between those two sort of revamped ETKs, while the Bajarama Estate would be down in 33rd place. Very, very close between that and the Hopper Limo. Again, it has been an episode of incredibly close vehicles. Apologise to the guy who's making the maps, because it could be really difficult to fit all of these on the thing. So sorry, sheep. Good luck with that. However, yeah, the Estate beating the 8x8 utility truck is pretty damn good going. That, though, is going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and as ever, I shall link all the mods I've used in the description so you can download them, have a go with them yourself. But until next time, goodbye.